You know Freddy Krueger is, the guy with the knives?
Oh, yeah.
3, 4, better lock your door.
Robert Englund played him.
5, 6, grab your crucifix.
How about that, huh?
7, 8, better stay up late. I forget.
Yeah, well.
9, 10, Bob's living in sin. You ready?
11, 12, Ross is an elf.
Yeah. 6 foot tall, 260-pound elf. That's what they're made of these days.
Well, you've seen the show Elf.
Yeah. I think I dress up as him every now and then.
Santa, I know him.
Good morning, Glencroft. Welcome to the B&R Show. My name is Ross. I'm the R. This is Bob next to me. He's the B. This is one of those experiences that you just can't stop looking at it. Why? It's awful. That's all there is to it. You know, we just do this for us. We think it's funny, and that's about it. So the two of us are the only ones that count. It's time right now to do that thing that we do. Cannot do this show alone. We got to bring Mr. Pearly Whites in right now. He is the inventor of eggs on a stick. He is the master of the anguish languish. People, stand up. You at Providence Place, stand up. Towers, stand up. Manor 1, Manor 2, stand up. The Villas, we see you there. Stand up. Courts, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Stand up. Wherever you are watching this right now, I am begging you to stand up and show this man some respect.
No!
Throw a few babies in the air. Catch them and help me right now. Welcome to the Glencroft Broadcast Studios. The one, the only, Bob! Theodore! I think I'm not going to do it today. This will be the only way we don't do it. Let's just move on. And now we're going to do the thing that we do else, and we pause. Theodore Newton! All I need to do is see his teeth. That's all I need. The pearly whites. Bob, welcome.
I knew it was coming.
Welcome, Bob.
It was a matter of time.
Bob, tell me about your weekend. Before we jump in, tell me one great thing about your weekend.
I got my daughter married off.
Well, it's about time.
I guess so.
That is room for some applause, some crowd laughter.
Amen.
Golf clap. Good.
Yes.
Well, Bob, before we get into all the things we need to talk about here on the B&R Show, we need to pause and honor those that have served and are serving in our country's National Armed Forces. This is our national anthem. Thank you.
Thank you for your service to our country.
Daughter married off.
Daughter married off Saturday, now, Glenwood, Iowa.
Have you met this fellow before?
Yes.
Had conversation with him?
Yeah, I asked him, are you sure this is what you want to do?
Yeah, and what did he say?
He said, do what?
Oh. Is that like marriage advice you gave him?
Yes.
Stay clueless?
Yep. I told him, you know, Never go to bed mad at each other, okay?
Oh, that's good.
Give each other a kiss goodnight.
That's good.
Yeah, absolutely.
Well, was it a good wedding?
Beautiful. It was outside in a resort area in eastern Nebraska.
Eastern Nebraska?
Yeah.
Nice.
Yeah.
Well, I hope it was great, Bob. Thanks for flying back so fast to record this show.
I'm so dedicated.
To be here on Tuesday morning. I know you are.
Yes.
A lot going on around here at Glencroft. Last week was a busy week. The big cruise ship, Glencroft, ported in Cuba. And we enjoyed some Cuban cuisines on Tuesday and Thursday. And then on Wednesday, some Spanish singing Cuban entertainment. Everybody said the music was great, just didn't really know what they were singing.
But it was good, yes.
It sounded like it was really, really good. And so this week will be a captain's dinner. It's the second week of Cuba, so that's going to be this coming Thursday night. It'll be in Henry's, the H Deck, at 5 p.m. And it's on a Thursday. So, Bob, what happens every single Thursday at 3:30?
A greet and meet or a mix and mingle.
Mixers and mingles. People are starting to get the hang of it. I think I told you last time it was really cool. And I talked to a man that was up there. I said, what are you doing? He goes, I'm mixing and mingling.
That's
it. I was like, great job. And he really was. He was moving from table to table saying hello.
And how much does that cost?
Just like the shuttle service, Bob, free.
Outstanding. My favorite word.
I thought it was plethora.
That too.
I thought it was plethora.
I have a plethora of favorites.
Right.
Yes.
So today is Tuesday. Looks like it's the 11th. Is that not right?
It is the 11th.
I can't remember what hour it is. I don't know what day it is. Yeah, Tuesday, October the 11th.
It's the 11th.
If you haven't noticed, Christmas is basically here. It's just around the corner. As soon as October hits, the year is over. So we are on the downward slope heading toward Christmas. Don't forget, Bob and myself love Christmas gifts, so start planning ahead and buying now. Sacrifice food, sacrifice monthly payments, sacrifice bills to make sure you have money to buy us nice gifts. We greatly appreciate that in advance.
And if Emil Yoder is watching this by any chance, I love your cinnamon rolls, Emil.
Oh,
Hint, 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 hint.
I went to see, Emil made some cinnamon rolls for a early morning staff meeting.
Oh.
Let me tell you, if you don't know, two things. One, there's a man on campus named Emil Yoder. Two, he makes amazing cinnamon rolls. Not does he make them, but he is a bit of a perfectionist with his cinnamon rolls, okay? He made them, handed them off to the kitchen staff. That next morning, they had to warm them up or bake them or something. I forget.
My.
And he was fired up because they baked them too long.
Uh-oh.
They were a little too light brown on the top. That's a man I like right there.
He says,
I have dialed it in. This makes the perfect cinnamon roll. You let them in for 0.3 seconds too long. They're horrible. Throw them out. Get some more. That's perfection.
That's perfection.
I like that.
Now, I don't know if you know this or not, but during our March auctions when they were here.
Yes.
Emil used to make cinnamon rolls and sell them at the March auction.
Well, he was at an all-campus social one time, and we quizzed him in front of the group on this.
Yes.
And do you know the number, the most he ever made? Do you remember?
1,700.
One man.
1,700.
1,700.
So he's got to get it right sooner or later, right?
Oh, he's got it right.
He's got it right.
All right. Like I mentioned, Captain's Dinner is coming up Thursday, October the 13th, 5 p.m., Henry's Cafe, the H-Deck. Another great night. The cruise continues. I do know that Towers is on schedule. On schedule means the end of October at the soonest, very early November should be complete.
Good.
And get back in there. And whenever that is, the cruise ship has to dock. But we've had so much fun. Don't worry. We will bring it back. It's a do again kind of thing.
That's a great run.
This Friday, October 14th, if you would like to go up to Mortimer Farms up in Dewey, kind of like as you're heading to Prescott, to enjoy some cooler weather, a family farm, grab a pumpkin, eat some good lunch, sign up at the Activity Center for the trip. It's $8, and you got to bring money for lunch, and if you want to buy a pumpkin, things like that, okay? But don't go and get tired, because that night in the auditorium, a Glencroft favorite, the Needham Twins, will be performing. It's a great, great night.
Usually
a packed house, isn't it?
I noticed you said performing. They don't sing. They perform.
Yes, and I've mentioned that, and I've talked with Patty about this. We have people that come in that they have a skill, and they show us their skill, and in a sense, they perform. And then there's entertainers, okay?
Yeah.
Those that are amazing, not only can they perform, but they also are entertainers. These guys bring it together. They are great at their craft, and they present it in such a way where you truly are entertained.
They are super duper. So, you can't miss them.
You know what? Bring somebody with you. Try, you know, reach across the hall or see somebody at lunch and say, hey, are you going to the Friday night? No, I normally don't go. Well, why don't you go with me this Friday night? Let's pack that room out.
Good idea.
You know, let's
great
pack
idea.
That room out, okay?
Good thing.
October 18th. Some of you are being a little sluggish last year. Maybe we made them mad. I don't know. We had to cancel the Olive Mill trip last year. It's back on schedule now for October the 18th.
Okay.
It's at Queen Creek. It's not that far away. We got a bus scheduled to pick us up, take us up there. It's a tour. It's a lunch. It's a great time. Get over to the to the Activity Center for this one and sign up. Okay. All of this stuff is in the October calendar. You've already got it in your hands. Just notice that there are stars and there's triangles because we try to make this more of an inclusive calendar for the month because you'll have activities on here. You have things being offered by resident services on here. Our marketing department has stuff on here. And also sometimes Community of Faith, they have stuff on here. And so please just read it, pay attention, look for the symbols on the side. It tells you at the bottom what each means and who you call to register. Lot of stuff going on. And then I mentioned that November, I think I mentioned it a week ago or something. I go to so many meetings and tell people stuff. I have no idea where it might have been on the air, but November is a fun month, okay? Most definitely the true kickoff of the holiday season. But in November, we do a couple fun things. One is Mad Hatter Week.
Yes.
Last year, I'm the one in charge of Mad Hatter Week, and I'm going to grade myself from last year. A D minus.
D minus.
It was still fun. All the after stuff we did was still fun, but on the level I want it to be and how I want to grow, I will give myself a D minus on that one. Okay.
Uh-oh.
Great twist this year. New things planned. It's really simple. During Mad Hatter Week, there's special events planned, and also wear a hat because if you wear a hat, you may get a surprise that week. A really great one. And they come in all shapes, forms, and fashions. Okay. Don't know what it is? Ask around. I'm not going to tell you too much today. That's in November. The Cowboy Campfire Cookout is in November. That's always a great time. I love that one.
And is that going to be outside by the...
It's going to be... Hopefully.
Hopefully.
Everything should be panning out the way we think it will. We'll be out there.
Up by the towers.
Yes.
Dining room. Yes.
Mm-hmm.
Good.
Those are good things. And then a big one that it's coming now, November 4th is a Saturday. Okay? November 5th. Is that right? I can't remember. I'll make sure I tell everybody the right date. Oh,
the 45th anniversary celebration.
Yeah, Saturday the 5th.
November 5th, yeah.
Saturday the 5th, the campus will be open to people we have invited, which residents are invited, resident families are invited, the community is invited, all the vendors we work with are invited, okay?
Prospective residents.
Celebrating 45 years here at Glencroft. It's a big party. It's labeled Tour the Town. People will travel from registration in front of marketing there, sales and marketing, and they'll ease on around through the property in each spot. They'll learn about the history of that location and those buildings and things like that. They'll get their card punched at each spot saying, hey, I stopped and heard the spill and stuff. There's free giveaways. Once your card is all punched and you filled your name out, you throw it into a hat for a drawing, you could win a great prize.
Donald Trump
free
and Hillary
food,
Clinton will be
free
here. No. Well.
Maybe the B&R Show should broadcast live that day.
Maybe, huh?
They'll put us in the fountain.
Donald Trump won't be here, huh?
No.
Oh, all right.
So anyway.
That was just a rumor that Jerry Chasen started.
Well, your first problem is you believe anything Jerry says. I got a bag of tacos for you.
I see.
All right, Bob, listen to this.
Okay.
Okay. Humor is a good thing. Bob and I believe in it.
Absolutely.
We live by it. Here's some humorous things we hope you enjoy. This one's titled, That's a Good Thing. A young boy was spending a Sunday afternoon with his grandpa. Looking at pictures of his grandpa in his military uniform, the boy asked, Grandpa, did you ever kill anyone in the war? No, champ. I never did. And that's a good thing. You're telling me, began Grandpa. I was only the cook.
Oh, well then. I was in the Army. There could be some killer cooks.
How was your cooking, Bob? Are you a good cook?
If it don't go in the microwave, I don't fix it.
Really?
Yeah.
You don't really have pots and pans. You just have a microwave and
there. Yeah, that's right. And then I'm so impatient, I stand by the microwave yelling, come on, come on.
Why do I believe that? Pass on the wings is the next one here.
Okay.
The flight attendant on the trip was handing out plastic pilot wings to some kids. As the young man stepped forward, she playfully offered some to him. He passed, pointing to the airborne wings on his Army uniform.
Uh-huh.
He explained, the last time someone gave me wings, I had to jump out of the airplane.
I'll pass on the wings. I like it.
I'd have another one, too. Let me find it. Where did it go? Do you have one?
I have one.
Go for it, because I've lost one, but go ahead.
Okay, I'll do this one, then you'll find that one.
Yes.
Okay. When Diane found out she was pregnant, she told the good news to anyone who would listen. Her four-year-old son overheard some of his parents' private conversation about naming the baby. One day when Diane and her four-year-old were out shopping, a woman asked the little boy if he was excited about the new baby. He said, yes, I am, and I know what we're going to name it, too. If it's a girl, we're going to call it Christina. If it's a boy, we're going to call it Quits.
Yeah, I was second born, so my parents couldn't do that.
I see.
But for some reason, we had no more kids.
I have one older sister. That's all I have.
So a lot of people here live in close quarters with neighbors, side by side. Some people live with neighbors above and neighbors below. We've all probably lived at some point in time in our life in apartments where you're just cram-packed in there.
That's right.
This one will make sense.
Okay.
This is called Piping Up, is the title of this one. A Scottish mother visits her son-in-law in New York City apartment and asks, how do you find the Americans, Donald? I guess that means, what do you think about the Americans?
Yes.
Mother, says Donald, they're such noisy people. One neighbor won't stop banging his head against the wall while the other screams and screams all night long. Oh, Donald, how do you manage to put up with them? What can I do? I just lie in bed quietly playing my bagpipes.
Playing my bagpipes,
well,
yes.
I wonder why they're banging their head and thinking like that.
Yes, I wonder why they're screaming.
I'm afraid I've had some of that kind of stuff in my
life. Make it stop.
Gotta take the broomstick and bang it on the ceiling above.
Yes,
you know,
of course.
Seriously. Well, that brings up an issue, Bob, that we're moving into a segment right now that we're going to call The Hauntings of Glencroft.
Oh, boy.
Thus, the scary scenery and the haunting music behind us going on right now. I guess haunting music. I guess haunting music really is not, you know, it can't be. I guess haunting music could be behind you.
It could be.
Speaking of which, my kids make this story all the time. They make fun of me because this is a true story. I used to ride a mountain bike a lot. I did not weigh 260 pounds at that time.
I see.
I was a much smaller person. And probably because I was riding a mountain bike all the time. You know, I was smaller. And I had gone my route through these trails up in the mountains all the way around, way past Gobi. It was probably like a 5-mile type loop. Okay, all around.
Right.
And I'm back on the road, home stretch, a couple more turns, back of the house. All of a sudden, kind of out of my peripheral vision, I see a bicyclist like on a 10-speed behind me. In his bright colored 10-speed outfit. I'm like, oh. I look away, I look back, and he's gone. Like that. No side roads, no place to go. Just right there. Desert. And so I stop the bike. And I look around, like, this isn't funny. Look all the way around, I'm like, he's probably hiding in a gutter somewhere behind him. No place to hide. I pedaled very fast on the way home. I was a scared little camper, a grown adult. Okay?
That's amazing.
What is the Hauntings of Glencroft? Well, let's talk ghosts. Those things that float around and say, boo, that's kind of scary. Dealing with some of those issues that kind of creep up and want to haunt you. Okay?
All right.
What would you guess some of those haunting things might be, Bob?
I have the slightest idea.
Well, let's deal with one right now.
Okay.
This is a haunting phrase that I hear all the time. And it's sad. It's all the time. You know, Ross, it's just not the same Glencroft. The staff just doesn't care about us anymore.
Oh.
Have you heard that one?
Yes.
You have. Well, let me tell you today, that is a ghost story. It may appear to be that way. It may seem to be that way. The problem is a thing called change. Change is not easily embraced around here. John Smith says, Ross, we're a senior adult crowd. Guess what? The number one fear is
change.
And change is a fearful thing. It really is. especially when you get older and you learn routines. Where are my keys? Hold on. For example, Susan Hornbostel, our COO, is talking about these things called fobs right here. Believe it or not, this little black disc is actually a key. It's not a key like this that we've all grown up with. It's now a key that looks like this, okay? This opens doors just like these can, okay? And people are fearful. They're like, why they keep changing? Well, believe it or not, with this little jewel right here, it functions just like keys and better.
It's easier.
Most people on our campus need really one key. They don't drive anymore. They don't have a collection of keys like we have to sometimes back in the day. This can be on a watch, believe it or not. It can be clipped on a string and pull out. And all you have to do is, I mean, and I know that you know this, I'm not speaking about you, but I mean, at my age now, at 46, my hands, trust me, don't work like they used to. And at 86, which key is it as you fumble around?
Yep.
There it is. Your eyes don't work so great, so you're trying to slide it in upside down. That doesn't work. You drop your keys, you pick them back up. Oh, you picked up the wrong key. Next thing you know, you've given up. You're going to call security because you can't get in your door, okay? And you got to get it and twist it. And all. Hey, one thing, close to the keypad on the door, not the keypad, a little pad there, the door clicks and it just opens right up, okay? Yep. Another beautiful thing is, let's say for some reason you're fearful, the hauntings of Glencroft, fearful that somebody has come into your place and this is the kind of lock you have. Guess what? Let's say for some reason I'm maintenance and Bob, you call in and you're like, excuse me, I think somebody's trying to get into my apartment. Somebody stole my cheese. We're like, oh my goodness, well, let's find out. And they pull up an electronic computer system and access your door lock because you have one of these. They can say, yes, somebody did come in at 12:06 p.m. in the afternoon. Maintenance, his name is Ross, and he fixed your sink. Bob says, oh, yeah, I forgot about that.
Uh-huh.
These little things do that. Because there's so much change, there's more change, staff changes, systems change, programs change. The way we do things around here, it just keeps on changing. And the easiest thing to say is, well, our staff really doesn't. They don't care.
Go with it.
Well, here's the deal. The change is because we want things to be better. People complained a lot about that front parking lot. Oh, my gosh, and moaned and groaned. What a wonderful front parking lot we have. No more curbs to step down and step up. It's completely level. So easy when buses load and unload.
Absolutely.
You drive.
Yeah.
How nice is that?
It's much better.
Beautiful fountain out there.
Much better.
You know, and then the quality of the asphalt we had before, it was done. I watched women walking across that thing and breaking heels off, okay? Now, nice, smooth, well-lit. They don't care about us anymore. They've got these gates around campus. Number one priority for all staff at Glencroft, safety, security for the residents. Period. No comma. Period. Having a secure campus is something that will continue to grow and evolve day in and day out, making this home where you live a safer place, a more secure place, not only for yourself, but those loved ones that have helped you get here, that's your family and your friends, knowing that, hey, Glencroft is doing the best they can to take care of you. Why do staff have to change? Why can't staff just stay here forever and ever and ever? It doesn't work that way. Some staff come and some staff go. There has been staff that's been here that I've hated to see leave, but you know what? Somebody else comes in. I used to run the audio visual on this campus for a little bit, okay? I have a very little bit of ability there. We have Oliver. Oliver
Amen.
Does a great job. What if I stayed doing that?
Thank heavens for Oliver.
There wouldn't be an Oliver. We love Oliver, but because I stepped aside and let somebody else come in, we now have Oliver. So I get it. Trust me, I get it. When we see staff come and go, that kind of hurts a little bit, but it's like I've always said, you know, get up and get out and get busy and look around and check out your hallways. Your new best friend could move in across the way. But if you're not out and about and being mixing and mingling, you may never meet them. Be glad that you've had some amazing staff here and be hopeful that more amazing staff will come in, okay? I do not include B and Bob in that. We're horrible and we know it, okay? Hauntings of Glencroft, things you really don't need to be fearful about. I promise you, the staff at Glencroft is doing all they can do to improve this place we live here, we work here, and make it better for the resident. Not make it better for us, make it better for the resident. Scary music is gone. Back to the B&R Show.
Okay.
Well, it was the B&R Show.
Well, now it's going to be the R&R Show.
That's right. Well, Bob, I hate to do it, but we have a segment we need to move in here now, and it's time to make you disappear. Presto, Theodore is gone, and Robert is now here. We have the best effects here on the B&R Show, like you have no idea. Many of you don't realize, but we recorded Robert last week, and Robert has to learn a lesson that you have to put your chin on the mic, otherwise you're not heard. And the audio was bad, and so we had to cut out Robert's part. But it's a new week, and Robert is back, and we've done some training. So he's ready to tell us all the great things going on in the world of transportation, and the word is already out there through some meetings last week, resident reps. There's a great new brochure. The brochure advertises a shuttle service. So, Robert, it's all yours. Lean into that mic, brother, and tell us what's going on.
So, good morning, Glencroft. Today, I will be discussing about this transportation shuttles. And a lot of changes have occurred. So, please, if you haven't already, grab one of these transportation services brochures. And we do have a lot of information on the inside. So, if you would take a look on the inside of it, we do have free shuttles. Monday through Friday and a Sunday.
Hey, what was that one word again? That one big word that's four letters there.
You know, free.
One more time. What was that again?
Free.
So if you want to go to Walmart,
if
you want to go to Walmart, how much does it cost?
Free.
What if you want to go down to like the movie theater on Northern right there? How much does that cost?
That will cost you actually 0.00.
Oh, it's a different number. What if you want to go to Kohl's and go shopping?
That would be free.
Oh, what about that store called Ross? I like that store, by the way. How much is that one?
Let me check here.
Yeah?
We got it free.
Oh, my God. What about Applebee's? The trip to Applebee's. How much does the trip cost to get you to Applebee's?
That's free.
Oh, my. The list is huge. The shuttle runs how many days a week?
5 days a week.
5 days a week.
1 day a weekend.
And 5 days a week, 1 day on the weekend, all right? These are available at the concierge. It's a free service. Now, Robert, let me play out a scenario here, okay? Let's say, when does this start? Let's go with that first.
It starts October 10th.
October 10th. So on October the 10th, that's a Monday, correct?
That's correct.
All right. Oliver shows up with 7 people. I show up with 13, and Bob shows up with nobody because he has no friends. And we all come there together and say, take us to the movies. What happens?
Well, the first shuttle will be first come, first serve. Second.
Whoa. First come, first serve. What does that mean? Is there a list?
There is a list.
Oh, my gosh. Do you mean we have to sign up for this?
Yes.
Go to the concierge. If you just show up, guess what? This is your routine. Wave as the shuttle leaves you behind. If you want to go, they have to know. Write that down. Get your pen out. If you want to go, they have to know. So if you just show up on a Tuesday wanting to hop and go for a ride, no, you got to get on the list, okay? And they can only seat how many?
We could only seat 12. And depending on if it's a wheelchair or scooter.
Right.
Then we could place that in.
Right. So it could hold a couple wheelchairs and about 13 people. That's it. And the shuttle stops about, you know, if let's say I get dropped off at the, that's Park West, okay? And you drop me off, I don't know.
Let's at the casino.
Number. All right. Well, Park West. Let's go to the movie theater, not the casino. At 9 a.m. Does it start at that early in the morning or whatever?
9 a.m.
All right. What time does the shuttle come back there for pickups?
It does come back at 10 a.m.
And then?
11 a.m.
And then?
1 p.m.
And then?
2 p.m.
All right. So here you go. You want to go to the movies. You hop on the shuttle. You get over there. You go to your movie. You get done with your movie. You go get some lunch. You get done with your lunch. Go back to the shuttle stop on the posted hours. If you read this, you'll understand that this shuttle is going to be moving and going and getting people all over this area for shopping and things like that. I've noticed on the back of the brochure, it talks about another feature in our transportation department, and that is for medical transport. That if you need to go to a doctor and there is a fee schedule for that. Zone 1 is my favorite fee. What? How much does it cost for Zone 1, Robert?
Zone 1 is free.
Oh, my gosh. Did you hear that, everybody? Zone 1. Golfers clap. It's in there. So you need to make sure your doctors are in Zone 1. If they're not, say, get your honeys moved to Zone 1 because Zone 1 is free for me. There's a Zone 2 and there's a Zone 3. Those are much farther out away from Glencroft, so there is a small fee to get out to those places, okay? All of this information available in the brochure located at the concierge over by Henry's. Stop by, see Debbie. Sometimes Robert's there if they don't have him working somewhere else. Pick it up, ask questions. If you want to go, they have to know. Sign up at the concierge. Theodore, get over here. Let's wrap this booger up. It's been another great day here on the B&R Show. Robert, you can hang out. He just leaves in. Thank you for tuning in. There's a lot going on. Get up, get busy, get connected, get clued in. Channel 2, Channel 4, The Informer. What else do we have? The Communicator, bulletin boards. There is so many things going on. You gotta get plugged in. Be a part of it and get active. And
good night, Mrs. Calabash, wherever you are.
Very good. That was a fast show. Feels like we just started.
I know it.
All right.
By the way.